It is an honor to welcome our first lady, Mrs. Suzanne Mubarak, and our keynote speaker today.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, youth ambassadors, African youth, and friends and partners for all our work we're doing with the ICT. It is a pleasure to welcome you all to Egypt on the occasion of the World Telecom and Information Society Day. Let me begin by congratulating the International Telecom Union, ITU, Telecom Africa 2008, for bringing together such an extraordinary congregation of leaders, innovators, youth, and change makers committed to advancing our common aspirations for peace and development in the African region. I have followed with great interest your deliberations over the past few days, noting with satisfaction and constant emphasis that you place through your initiatives on empowering people to achieve personal security and actively participate in shaping their societies through the use of ICTs. Let me also congratulate you for consecrating this year's award to the efforts exerted in eliminating the hardships experienced by individuals with disabilities under the theme Connecting Persons with Disabilities, ICT Opportunities for All. In this context, I am delighted to accept this award as a symbol of what we have all achieved together in enhancing the lives of people with disabilities, and as a testament that we still have a long way to go and what we can accomplish together in the future. Today, as a result of the massive advances in ICTs, we are equipped more than ever before to face the momentous challenges posed by the magnitude of the problems of disabilities. ICTs have the power to break down barriers, connecting vulnerable and marginalized groups with their communities, and build capacities for self-fulfillment. They are real enablers, and their potential for change does not cease to astonish us all. In Egypt, we are greatly investing in utilizing ICTs to rekindle the hope of the disabled by increasing their confidence, their independence, and by giving them a sense of control in their lives. In partnership with relevant stakeholders, including the private sector and NGOs, we have been drawing on these powerful technologies to provide a better quality of life, facilitate access to educational, employment, and social opportunities, as well as in providing professional rehabilitation and awareness programs. We have been working hard to enhance the skills of trainers and educators to make the maximum use of the ICTs in their capacity building programs. In turn, all these initiatives have opened new horizons for the disabled in terms of networking, solidarity, jobs, and independent living. Through our initiatives, we are also supporting and encouraging innovation in the use of the universal designs for genetic software and assistive technology products, as well as introducing accessibility techniques to meet their needs. In this regard, we are proud of our IT clubs that serve these technologies in all our governorates, and we are in the process of developing more mobile units to strengthen our presence in remote and underprivileged areas across the country. Furthermore, we are currently working to tailor our education programs for the disabled, introducing modern educational aids and equipment, and modifying the curriculum to respond to the students' needs with a particular focus on skill development through ICT. However, ladies and gentlemen, in spite of the progress that I have just outlined, there are still considerable challenges that we must address in order to maximize the impact of our endeavors. We still have a very long road ahead. Across the region, the majority of disabled persons have become victims of the digital divide as they continue to face numerous barriers in terms of access to ICTs themselves and the skills required to use them effectively, while some suffer from lack of awareness and training opportunities
many others simply cannot afford the steep cost of acquiring, installing, and maintaining computers, as well as obtaining special assistive hardware and special needs software. Unfortunately, the problem of discrimination is also still very much alive throughout our societies. Lack of awareness about equal opportunities and rights often hinders their ability to participate in socioeconomic and political sectors, as well as in the processes of development tailored to meet their needs. We need to reverse these negative trends by listening to people with special needs and integrating their insights, their ideas, and their solutions into our policies and initiatives. In my capacity as a social worker for many years, I have had the chance to work with adults, children, and youth with different disabilities and impairments. And I can assure you that their world, despite the obvious frustrations, is a fascinating one, filled with promise, courage, endurance, special joys, and remarkable success stories. And I would just like to take a moment here to give a very special tribute to our girls from Wafa Ul Amal, the Light of Hope Association. A vivid example of how young Egyptian women, in spite of their disabilities, had been able, with courage, endurance, and special skills, to produce what we will hear today as an orchestra of first class, international first class music, which will be performed today. Shukran wujudkum ma'ana al-naharda, wa rahab bil banati min al-Nur.
Thank you for your presence with us. Once again, I should like to welcome my daughters from the Light and Hope, Al-Nur wal-Aman.
For many of these people who I was fortunate enough to get to meet, genuine empowerment, like for all of us, means being able to uphold their dignity and exercise their human rights. It entails feeling being part of a community that helps to meet their needs and values their contributions. It represents having the opportunity to participate, knowing that others will respect their views and beliefs. For some of the young minds I worked with, for example, in our Special Olympics programs, empowerment signifies getting the opportunity to engage in sports activities, both at the national and international levels, building their self-esteem and developing the inner strength that can enable them to break free from their disabilities and realize their full potential in life. It is by listening to these individuals, by recognizing the obstacles that they face in their everyday lives, that I would like to stress today the importance for all of us to develop more inclusive strategies to address this very serious developmental issue. Within this context, we need to strengthen our partnerships and alliances and together find ways of removing these obstacles that face disabled persons, making ICTs more accessible, affordable, and rewarding without geographical or socioeconomic discrimination. We must ensure the implementation of national, regional, and international instruments and declarations that promote the positive use of ICT, and we must also recognize and support their rights as citizens and participants in their communities' social and economic activities. I believe that the Cairo Declaration that issued last year as the outcome of the regional conference on sharing experience on best practices in ICT services for persons with disabilities is a very positive step in this direction. And I hope that our coordinated work will continue to contribute in furthering ties of cooperation between all relevant partners in the Arab and African region. Ladies and gentlemen, in pursuing our objectives, we must recognize that youth are our hope for an equitable and peaceful information and knowledge society. It is essential, therefore, that we use every opportunity to empower them, to maximize the benefits of this new era of technology with innovative ideas and practices, and work with them as equal and active partners. Indeed, I still clearly recall the declaration presented in a previous ITU youth forum. I have not yet seen today's declaration, but I think we will have it with us very soon, where the youth committed themselves to using ICTs as a tool to promote peace, friendship, democracy, justice, and love throughout the African continent, and they called upon their leaders to do likewise. As a response, the Suzanne Mubarak Women's International Peace Movement organized an international youth forum in September 2007 in Sharm el Sheikh under the banner The Youth of Power, The Power of Youth. Youth speak, we listen. And ladies and gentlemen, listen we did to 800 young leaders from all over the world, youth that were determined and confident in their collective ability to eliminate violence and build a more peaceful and sustainable world. The Cyber Peace Initiative that emanated from this forum has put into practice the dreams and aspirations for these young leaders of using ICT as a tool to promote intercultural understanding and tolerance between nations, enhance human security across borders, and foster a culture of peace in the hearts and minds of global citizens. I'm so pleased to see many of our youth leaders here, what we refer to now as the youth ambassadors, the Net Amalians, our African youth partners, all are with us here today. And I would like to invite and welcome the African youth who attended the cyber peace camps in these last 2 days to join us in this exciting new initiative. Just before we entered here, I had the chance of meeting with a group, with a number of these wonderful African youth who are with us. Please stand up so everybody can see you, the youth that are with us today. Give them a good applause. A wonderful group of young people who have come from all over Africa to be with us in our Cyber Peace Youth Camp. And we have promised and committed ourselves to cooperate and work harder, to network, and to make sure that the youth of Africa work together to make this continent the best place in the whole world. So, ladies and gentlemen, as we celebrate together the World Telecom and Information Society Day, let us reaffirm our dreams and rededicate ourselves to the well-being of our continent and its technological advance. And let us open the doors to the resourcefulness and ingenuity of our African youth and provide them the opportunities to take on the challenges of improving the conditions of the continent and watch them rise to the occasion. I thank you all and wish you a very joyful and pleasant day.